Hello and welcome to another video in our course on cell biology and genetics. In this video, we are going to talk about the central dogma of molecular biology. So what are you going to learn in this video? First, I'm going to explain what the central dogma of molecular biology is and how the genetic information flows in the organism. We are also going to talk about how the theory has changed since it was first formulated. After watching this video, you will also understand the terms reverse transcription and RNA replication. By the way, you can find written notes on what we're going to discuss today at medicinecanbeeasy.com. The link is also in the description. The central dogma of molecular biology is a theory that explains the flow of genetic information in an organism. The theory originally stated that genetic information flows in three possible ways: DNA replication, transcription, and translation. In DNA replication, the DNA molecule duplicates, producing two molecules of DNA from the original one DNA molecule. The genetic information therefore passes from one DNA molecule to another. In transcription, an RNA molecule is synthesized based on the information stored in the DNA. In other words, the DNA code, usually containing information on how to synthesize a protein, is transcribed, rewritten, into RNA. In translation, a protein is synthesized from the transcribed RNA molecule. The information therefore passes from RNA to protein. The theory stated that genetic information passes in a one-way information pathway, which means that it is not possible to synthesize DNA from RNA. It is also not possible to synthesize RNA or DNA from a protein. However, it was discovered that genetic information can be passed in other ways. In retroviruses, it is possible to transfer information from RNA to DNA. This is called reverse transcription. What is more, some RNA viruses replicate their RNA. This is called RNA replication. This means that today it is believed that there are five possible information pathways: DNA replication, transcription, translation, RNA replication, and reverse transcription. Okay, so this is it. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful and you'd like to watch more videos on genetics or medicine in general, please subscribe. Thank you again and see you soon.